All right, so in the previous video, we covered how you can generate vertex colors and bake them in Blender. And now we're going to be talking about how that data can be used in Unreal Engine. So the first thing you'll need to do is import your mesh and make sure that you have your vertex colors imported with it. If you missed that, you can come over to your static mesh properties or details panel here and select vertex color import. Make sure it's set to replace. And then re-import your mesh. Once you have your mesh, you'd want to go ahead and create a material. And we're just going to look at one that I've created already to demonstrate what's happening here. So this material has no use of its UV map, and everything is based on world-aligned textures that are being projected onto it. So we can procedurally change the characteristics of this, such as changing between light or dark edges, or adjusting the fall off of the edge wear. The influence of the height maps. And I've also just added a paint layer here. That's being driven by one of the vertex color channels. So you can see, just to demonstrate that. So essentially, what we're doing here is we have a vertex color node. If we throw this on here, you can see that, so just like in the previous video, the noise that was baked into this mesh is being output by this vertex color node. And if we go into our red channel and unlit here, you can see here's our baked in vertex color ambient occlusion, which looks great. Here is the curvature. This might not show up really well on video, but there that is. Here is the thickness map. This could be useful, especially for subsurface scattering, for example. It's not really useful for a metal object like this pipe, but this is just for demonstration. And again, lastly, we have our noise in the alpha channel. So inside the material itself, this is going to look a little complicated, but this is, again, just for demonstration to show off what this effect can do. We've got world-aligned textures so that we don't need to rely on a UV map, and world-aligned normals that are also driving a height lerp here to mix between them. And the vertex color is driving that height lerp. So in this case, I'm using the curvature here in the green channel and using that to lerp between where the dark color and the light color appear. And I'm using the red channel here to, which again holds the ambient occlusion texture or vertex color data, to apply that yellow paint. So nothing too special happening there. But one limitation I wanted to talk about briefly, because I think it's probably a big factor in deciding if this technique is right for your asset, is visible if we come over into this third material, which is using the random noise I showed previously, as well as the curvature. So what I wanted to show you is that because Nanite is removing vertices based off of the detail it thinks you need to see, that means that you can lose your vertex color data based on the distance you are from the mesh, and that can affect your result. So this is particularly noticeable on areas that are flat and don't require much geometric detail to represent the shape of the object. But it's not going to really be a problem on areas like edges and high detail areas that Nanite is naturally going to try to preserve the detail for. But you'll notice that as we move away from this mesh, the vertex color data, the noise in particular, begins to disappear, and you get this sort of texture popping effect. And as you come back in, the vertices get added back in, and it gets closer to resembling the full bake. So there are some limitations to this technique given the way that Nanite is designed, and you want to be careful. I think it's especially powerful for things like procedural edgeware, where the majority of the vertex data is going to be using things that are focused on the edges and areas of high geometric detail. Another thing that's going to generally work well are more interpolated or smooth masks. So, for example, if this noise was smooth, which I might be able to just quickly show if we come in here and plug it in directly. If it's smooth like this, it's better able to interpolate between the vertices as that detail disappears, and it's not nearly as noticeable that that data is going missing. So just something to be aware of when using this technique, and some workarounds that you can use to make the most out of the high geometric detail that Nanite is bringing to the table. So hopefully you find this helpful, and thanks for watching.